Amen, lies. We saw it coming. And now that the reality is here, we have to do the work to address what we have to deal with. But there are people who are doing this work right now. And I am encouraged by so many of them each and every day. I've been very blessed to work with some of them, and I've been able to watch some of their work from afar. But there are people who are standing bold, who are working hard, who are going out each and every day to fight for communities, to fight for families, and have used their experiences to make the world a better place. And so we're going to honor these people today. Honor their work. Not that they stop working after they're being honored, but that this is an encouragement to keep on pushing, to keep on fighting, to keep speaking out in spite of whatever you're dealing with, in spite of what you may face, that people see the good work that you do. And we want to bring all the good work together. And so I want to call you up to come and accept these awards, these certificates of recognition, because we want to thank you for the work that you do. And we even ask that we give you about a minute, maybe two, to just let the community know who you are, what you do. You don't know who's in here, who may need your help today. And so we want to make sure that you have an opportunity to speak just for a couple minutes. My pastor always said there's a buzzer somewhere, but it's never went off on me yet. But to come speak to our community. And I just ask that we just give these people a round of applause, because sometimes you don't hear that you're doing the right thing. And people need to know that what they're doing is making a difference in our community. The first person I'm going to call up is a sister that I care for very dearly and I've been blessed to work with. She's a leading voice as it relates to tolerance in the Muslim community. And she's really been working hard to build a bridge across ethnicities, across race, across religious lines, to make sure that we can do a better job cooperating with one another. And she's been advocating strongly for our Somali community, and I thank her for that. I want to call Ms. Deeqo Jibril up and give some peace.
Salaamu Alaikum. May peace be with you, my dearest brothers and sisters. My name is Deeqo Jibril. I am a Somali refugee and activist here in Boston. And Jason and inspired me a lot. We work together. And I do want to thank the people that nominated me. I want to thank the people that supported me to get nominated. I also want to thank somebody I admire dearly who motivated me to see his work and to help me become the woman I am. Mr. Smalls, your work means a lot. Thank you for reaching out to the vulnerable refugee communities that nobody tells them you guys are welcome and you can be at the table. There are 8,000 Somalis in Boston who came here as a refugee like myself, and we are part of the fabric of America. But sometimes we don't feel welcome in the streets. I myself experienced a hate crime. The reason I reached out to the police is our youth feeling vulnerable. And I told the commissioner that we didn't come here to have a life of criminal. You know, we want to be treated respectful. You know, where I come from, it takes a village to raise a child, and we want to be that village. So Mr. Small said we need to have the 2,000, I will increase the number, we need to have 4,000 in the streets of Boston. Yes, we can. There are a lot of youths that want to be leaders. Myself, I was a woman who I've been told I cannot be a leader because I'm a woman, I should be in the kitchen taking care of my children. I proved them that I can do both. I'm also a woman who... being told you're Somali, you're refugee, you're Muslim, how can you be a candidate for the city of Boston? Didn't the president ban you? So I want to show my fellow Bostonian that Washington is not in charge. God is in charge. This will bring, you know, very special and dear to my heart. And I want to, there are 70,000 Africans, and I want to reach out to them and bring them to this church. We have to start a dialogue, you know, the power of unity, we don't realize it. Somali is not too far from here. I'm the founder of a mall. Come to 1127 Harrison Ave. There's an African mall. You know, get to know one another, and anything that Mr. Small is involved, I am on it. By any means necessary. I just want to end my favorite quote from Dr. King. We might all have come in on different ships, but we're in the same boat. So let's make our boat.